There were plenty of tears shed at the Jungle 12 months ago when Castleford Tigers dropped out of top flight rugby for the first time in their history. For Chief Exec Richard Wright, an immediate return is vital.
There were a lot of problems in the early days, and we didn't know what the financial outcome would be, how many fans would stick with us, how many sponsors would stick with us, so a lot of problems early on. We always said this would be probably our best chance of getting back up. You know, the club needs to go up, and I think for the fans it's very important.
But even if coach Dave Wood succeeds in the grand final against Whitehaven, he may still lose his job.
Are you going to stay?
I don't know. No idea. Want to stay, it's up to the board. The board have to make that decision.
Dave's done a good job this year, and we haven't made any decisions on coaching.
I've given up a business back home and brought my family over here and want to stay here for, you know, a long time.
In contrast, rival head coach Steve McCormack could probably have a job for life at Whitehaven. This is by far the most successful time in their history. And on Sunday morning, there's a huge exodus from Cumbria to witness to see if Steve can lead them into Super League for the first time. The team had set off the day before and were preparing at their HQ in Haydock.
What you've achieved so far has been outstanding. I think we all know that, and I think it, you know, it doesn't take me to say, I think we've got a lot of special people in the room and a special team. Now, you're 18 minutes away from doing something which a lot of players would give the right time for doing. So the main thing is enjoy it, and we know that on our day we'll beat anybody. And let's make sure it is our day.
So it's win or bust, and defeat for the Tigers would leave their cheerleaders, the KC Claws, feeling rock bottom.
Today's really make or break for us, because if we don't win today, then we're going to lose all our sponsors, so we won't have a job next season. So we don't want it to be the end, not today.
But whatever happens, the post-match party is already planned.
You know, we need a Tiger Bar and have a few hours like you did. And we go to Escape and have like a few bite to eat, and then we go up the pond. And then if we're lucky, we might get a free taxi home with one of the players.
Come on, lads, do it for the girls!
So with a Super League spot at stake and so much more, let battle commence.
We'd rather be playing Whitehaven today than OKR. Fact.
Come on, Cass!
We are Cumbrians.
We are here to win this grand final and go back to Super League, but rugby league's a funny game and any side can beat any side on the day.
There's nothing between both sides to prefer. We've played each other four times. Castleford spanked us twice and we've beaten them twice, so it's all about what happens on the day.
Yeah, we're going to be a close game. It's a tremendous atmosphere. I didn't realise it would be this big a crowd at it. But I just come looking at the cheerleaders, mate.
You know what's at stake here today. Let's make sure we do it.
This one's going to be good. Like I said, it's not always going to go away out there today. A ref makes a call, you fucking switch on, get back in position, get on with it.
Forwards. Same as every other game, but this game is even more important. Huge responsibility, you've got to tackle your ass off. Run as hard as you can.
Share your courage. Never let a teammate down. Play for them every minute. Keep faith in your teammates on your left and your right. Cover their backs like they will yours.
Keep our composure. Let's build pressure. The old key to the game is building pressure. Don't allow them to build any of it as well.
Deal with all types of attack, treachery and devious tactics. Take them all in your stride. On your young shoulders rest the future hopes of your people. This battle is not with the people of Whitehaven, but with the opponents on the field.
Last thing I'll say is have confidence in your own ability. Back yourselves, everything you do. Everything you do, you back yourselves. 80 minutes and we're winners again.
Be the hunter, not the hunted. Move swiftly and aggressively against your opponents and destroy them. Be the world's most feared and professional sporting team. And finally, demonstrate to all there is no better teammate and no worse opponent than a Castleford Tiger.
We'll taste the tension and feel the nerves. These are two sides aching for a place in Super League. And this is a day when dreams are made, but hearts are also broken. It's Castleford who get first touch of the ball, wearing their predominantly black strips. There's Hepworth playing his last game for Castleford this afternoon. An emotional occasion this is going to be for him. He's off to Leinster Rugby Union at the end.
Second, all there.
And Castleford are finding themselves in a very good position here. Smith to the middle. Henderson trying to feed it on again, looking for the big man Watini to make the burst, but it's well marshalled in defence by Whitehaven. Back to the middle. Davis with the dummy. Oh, he was taken high. Oh! And Aaron Lester holds his hands up in apology. Oh, that's a nice sight, the two veterans having a word with each other.
He sent Kearney off last week for less than that.
Richard Fletcher steadies himself for a big moment in a big game. Off he steps, right footed, and it's as true as you like. And Castleford had the opening score. Terrific support inside the Halton Stadium. It's a stadium record crowd watching on this afternoon. 13,000 plus. Henderson. His brother's looking forward to a grand final in the Super League next week. Little chip by Davis on the set. Was he blocked by Joe? Yes, he was.
High shot again.
Obstruction, and Davis is down again. In fact, it might be worse than obstruction. Steve Ganson, the referee, has stopped the clock.
Late challenge on the kicker, Ollie. Just have a double look.
There's a card coming out. Eventually. Which colour? It's yellow.
Hey, hey! Calm down!
Leroy Joe is into the sin bin.
Who's got the clock on that? Have you got the 10 minutes on that?
Worries for the coach. His side are down to 12 men for the next 10 minutes. Fletcher to add the two, and Castleford double their lead. The boots of Richard Fletcher has struck twice now. It's Whitehaven 0, Castleford 4.
Penalty wouldn't be so bad. Penalty to us wouldn't go down too bad.
Shenton. Here's Smith. Henderson. Davis. Spinning it wide again and flat. Almost finding a way through. Whitehaven's defence recovering quickly, but can they recover again? It's Hubert. He's over. Just on from the substitutes bench. And Craig Hubert proves to be an inspiration and a hero for his side. He's got a chance to add to the good work as well here. He's the regular goal kicker when he's on the field, so it's a natural duty he assumes. Having scored the four, he has not managed to add the two. He's put it wide.
He's got to kick them.
Henderson to Davis. Davis with a step. There's Henderson in support. They are just beginning to boss things in midfield, aren't they, Castleford, as Hubie takes it on again.
Four.
A lot of wisdom, a lot of talent in there, as Davis just pushing it on for Frank Watini, who does well to offload, and now there's gaps out wide. Can they exploit? Fieldville puts it back on the inside, and it's going to be another one for Crouch. Stephen Crouch with a diagonal run. Twice in as many minutes, Castleford have struck. And they really have grabbed a hold of this game now.
Same message, Pete. Tell them not to panic. But, hey, but we need a big improvement. We need a big improvement.
Here, simple kick. Simple result. It's nil for Whitehaven. It's 14 for Castleford. Smith again. This hockey. Summers just about keeps hold. Solid set of six so far here as Smith takes it on again. It's good, clean, clinical stuff. They'll be looking for a decent finish now with a kick. Here's Davis to provide it. Takes it as far as he can to the line. Up it goes. Calvert's under pressure. Oh, what a catch! And what a score by Damian Blatch! In the flicker of an eye, Whitehaven Super League hopes and aspirations have been snubbed it is Castleford who are on the march. They appear to be unstoppable now.
We need to stick to the method. The method. This is when they came back into it last time. We don't let them back.
Craig Hume will be claiming responsibility for this. It was the moment he came on the field that things turned around. Chance or not, but he has kicked the goal. It's another two.
What's the matter with that? Come on.
Here's Leicester, spinning it back to the middle, and then hammered in, but hammered back.
Third, Steve. Good effort.
Correct defending again. Hill, inside ball to C.
Four boys, make the line, Dion.
Here's Leroy Joe. Oh, and Davis with the interception. Brilliantly read. And what a try. Rips the heart out of Whitehaven. He's 37 years of age. He's seen it all before. And the old legs still work too. Not just the brain. Is that it? Greg Hubie can barely control the smile on his face as he prepares to take this kick-up goal. Right in front of the sticks, it's a simple two. And Castleford lead now by 26 points to nil.
How exciting this for me.
Here comes Joe, spinning it left again. It's Summers who's repelled. Seeds gets it on, just kept alive by Calvert. Calvert comes searching to the middle again. Out comes that Casimir defence. They've lost 20 yards. Calvert's lost his head. Oh, it's a nice step. Penny almost through. Dragged down desperately. Picked up by Sice. Sice now goes searching. Look at that desperate Casimir defending. Picked up by Penny once again. Six tackle. Spun away. Leicester lost it. Knocked on. Picked up. It's too many knocks on. The referee says hand over and Castleford will survive. Whitehaven are looking gloomy. Brad Davis is claiming that he's been bitten by one of the Whitehaven players.
Carl Sice. Okay. All right, yeah. You go away. I don't need any of you. I can deal with the touches. Go away, don't need you neither. We have a complaint of biting and there's a bite mark visible, so be quiet.
Michaela, what are we doing? I bit.
What?
It must be
the bit. Touches has witnessed a bite mark. We've not seen anything. The incident goes on report and we restart over there with an handover.
You dirty bugger.
All right. Get on with it. First. Down now.
But we're into the last 15 seconds of the first half now. It's been a fantastic first 40 minutes from Castleford's point of view. They might already have done enough. Whitehaven have 40 minutes left to keep their hopes alive. The hooter sounds and Castleford are joyous. They go in at the break, leading by 26 points to nil.
So, a nightmare half for Haven, but the Tigers were doing cartwheels.
We were in this position 2 weeks ago, boys, and we blew it. We threw it away. We ain't doing it today. The game's there for yous. So let's make sure we go out there this half and lift that intensity even more, raise that bar to a newer, higher level, and really take this game by the scruff of the neck.
We came back from 18-0 down on our place. We could have just done with a score before half-time. A score before half-time might have helped us, but not looking very good at the moment.
40 minutes of footy to work your rings out and get a job done, all right? And we started in November to get a job done. Let's show all these people that have been writing us off. Let's make sure we do it. Mates win for mates. Remember that. Mates win for mates.
Whitehaven somehow have to find a way of scoring 5 tries in this second half and keep Castleford from scoring any more. Otherwise, their dreams are over. Chambers.
Four.
It's Sice who's moved up to acting half again. Tandy. He's done well.
Five.
It's got them a bit more daylight. Now they need another big kick, though. To work very hard here. In fact, they've gone for the run and they've given it away, and for the second time it is Brad Davis, the poacher extraordinaire, and he celebrates. He knows there's no stopping Castleford now. Two points added by Johnny Hepworth on his final game for Castleford. They now lead by 32 points to nil.
Surely the cow come back now.
Taking his backer away from us.
Well, he can relax now, David Woods. He knows the job is done, surely. If Whitehaven do make the Super League this year, we've got a fantastic story to tell you in the next 29 minutes. That's a good driving run by Adam Wotini. And Castleford are moving within sight again here. Handful spins it to Davis. Davis plays it short. Good offload, good hands. Simple stuff, simple, simple stuff. Hockey's in, Castleford have another. It's all over Barber celebrating now for those Castleford fans. Now, did Tommy Hockey over-celebrate his try?
He's calling Tommy out, is he? Calling Tommy out for grabbing his badge. He is kidding, this bloke. Hey. He is kidding.
I know it's the final and I know you please. It's a showpiece occasion. You have responsibilities as a senior player not to incite the crowd. OK, take it on board, mate. Right.
We've copped shit all year from their fans.
Come on, Whitehaven, come on!
Whitehaven going back to the well and going very, very, very deep to try and pull something out. That's a good driving run by Ryan Tandy, who's taken them that close. Penny spins it back to the middle. Here's run out wide. Seeds with a step and Seeds with a try. Seeds of hope. Well, maybe too little too late, but at last they have something to cheer.
Come on, Whitehaven! That's quite like it, come on!
Got an extra man on the field as well. There he is. Thankfully wearing shorts. Wants to get involved in the Whitehaven line, he would do well to get away. It's Whitehaven who are pressing here again. Price doing well in defence. He simply dragged hold of Wesley Wilson, taking him out of the game. Davis. Henderson, it's taken on again by Hubie, but well matched in defence this time. And from Dummy Hall, Shenton, has he got it down? Referee is going to put the square in the air here and ask the question. It's one for the video referee. This is the decision. No try. At least something goes Whitehaven's way today.
Wait till I tell you.
Less than 3 minutes to go. Whitehaven looking to go down with their heads held high. Thrown out by Penny, here comes Seeds, it's going to be a try for Calvert. But it is a try that is barely worth celebrating because the game was up a long time ago. Castleford will enjoy this moment for as long as they possibly can. There's a lot more hard work to come next year. Whether he'll be there or not, we'll have to wait and see. But just for the moment, they are planning a party. Into the final 10, you can hear the countdown. Whitehaven haven't done yet. They want to carry on for as long as they can, but it's over. It's over for Whitehaven. And the waiting is over for Castleford. They're back where they always thought they always belong. Their time spent in the wilderness has been kept to just 1 year. Super League Rugby League will return to Weldon Road and the jungle. For Whitehaven, it'll be another 12 months of trying. They'll celebrate this long and hard amongst those Castleford fans. Castleford are back in the Super League.
Told you I'd do it, Rich.
Great job,
I told you I'd do it.
this.
Right, then.
Don't mind if we do ourselves justice, Steve, but we're not another.
No, well, this ain't... Last year was bitter.
Right, Dave?
Fuck, man, we did it, bud. We fucking did it, man. Fuck.
Scintillating performance, best performance of the season. We've saved it for the last, but a great performance, and we're back in Super League, so everybody's absolutely... can't express the words.
Is it back to the safe now and get that contract out for Dave Woods for next season?
I don't know. A lot of decisions will be talked through this week, but I would like to thank Dave for the work he's done this year and the special group of players that we've got here this year who've done a great job for us today.
Did you in your wildest dreams envisage that kind of scenario today?
I did, actually, yeah. We spoke about it and I said if we play the way we should have been all year and we get our method right, which is what we've been working on over the last few weeks, that we'd put 40 past them.
We've not done ourselves justice today, I don't think, with the performance, but I think I'll put it to Castleford. The performance has been absolutely outstanding and blew us away in the first half and they thoroughly deserve it. I think if you look at the overall picture, the players in there, every one of them, who's worn the shirt this year can be immensely proud. They've created a little bit of history, and what they've achieved is unbelievable.
It's a rugby league town through and through, and sometimes for me, my feelings, like the same as Adrian Bowers, it runs deeper than just a surface level, you know. There's a massive boost, a massive injection of positive news, and you know, it's great that we're Castleford back in Super League.
But for Dave Woods, the man who's led them there, he still has no idea of his future at the club. However, for now at least, the Tigers' rocky patch is over.
Rising up, straight to the top. I got the guts, got the glory. I went the distance, not gonna stop. Just a man with a will to survive.